move back or do something back. Something's going to always land, isn't it? So
every time you're backing up, you're giving the guy that range to get you, aren't you?
Make some noise for Scott Hammer!
Fight card again.
Yeah, who do we have now? We've got Scott Hammers.
Oh, Scott Hammers and Kyle Powell. The Titans gym in Colwyn Bay.
Okay.
Aaron Whitley and John Carter's gym, I believe, in Colwyn Bay.
Ah, yes.
And introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner. This is please give an ovation to Kyle Power!
This will be boxing, free boxing, free 2 minute round boxing.
Rocking in the free world.
Gonna have to fight me demons not to go out after this show, Gary.
Gonna be deaf after this. But what did he say? I'll risk one ear.
Ladies and gentlemen, your official introduction. The following boxing bout matched at 60 kilograms is scheduled for 3 2-minute rounds. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, he proudly represents Manchester Fighters, Scott Hammer! And introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner, he is aged 18. And Pirelli represents Titans. Make some noise for Kyle Power!
And Titans gym, is that in Llandudno?
Colwyn Bay.
Colwyn Bay?
Colwyn Bay.
Okay.
Yeah.
I think he was doing kickboxing the last time, wasn't he?
Yeah.
Here we are. We've got our second fighter from Manchester. Whoa! Wild. They were wild.
Nice little spin from the fighters there. Kyle's...
Scott Hammers looks like he's just throwing haymakers.
Yeah, yeah.
Where Kyle is very, very technical, throwing some really nice straight shots.
Nice right to the body.
Yeah, once again, same shot again.
And again, don't wait. Now, one, two, let's go, come on.
Kyle needs to keep his hands up when he's coming back after his combination. And I think that's when Scott's decided to throw these haymakers.
Yeah.
You know yourself, it'll only take one of them for to connect.
Yeah.
With a nice, good right hook by Scott there.
And when Scott, Scott's on the go, he looks like he's on the hunt. You know. Kyle's
throwing some nice combinations. They're landing on the gloves, but he's throwing.
They look good. Yep. He dominated the center of the ring most of the time as well. He still looks very composed. Doesn't look like he's gassed out at all.
Definitely.
A street fight more than anything else.
Yeah, yeah.
You know.
The old Weatherspoon special. Oh, big sweeping right hand by Scott there, never landed.
Nice combo. Kyle's explosive.
Very, very, very good.
but Scott is relentless.
Got Aaron Whitley in his corner as his obviously his trainer.
Yeah.
Aaron used to fight the same. Aaron's aggressive. He was heavy-handed.
Was it? Yeah.
A good fighter. It's nice to see that he's passing it on to his fighters. Kyle's hands are down. It's a bit dangerous.
Especially when he's when Scott's throwing those haymakers.
Yeah, yeah. Scott's taking more. So you know he's got a little bit more energy than Kyle. Maybe if he unleashes, but he has to unleash. It's a nice right hook, Scott.
Yeah. See those hands are dropping, eh?
Another right hand.
Yeah.
Kyle's hands needs to be up high.
Yeah.
That's it. He needs to step round rather than run round.
The minute those shots are getting thrown out, your hands need to come back, protect.
Definitely. Scott's body's open. Kyle with a couple of body shots after them heads. Waiting, I think getting a bit tired now.
Bit of a slip there in the corner.
Bit of a slip on the ring.
It is wet over here in this corner.
Another good round for Kyle. Spot on.
Yeah, I agree. I guess it was like what I was talking to Erica about with you can't be a one-trick pony.
No, definitely not.
It's gonna get long in the tooth after a while.
Exactly. And the combinations that Kyle is throwing out, you know, you don't want to be a one-trick pony against somebody like that.
Yeah. Yeah, absolutely. That was nice. Good straight. Once again, same thing. 1, 2, 3. He's caught Scott a couple times like that now.
Yeah.
Starting to pick through Scott's defense, I think.
Ooh, lucky with a hook.
Again, see the 1, 2, 3. Kyle needs to not get sucked into that.
Definitely does. Same again. His hands need to be up. See,
yeah.
Every time he goes back, his hands are coming down, and Scott's throwing a loop in right.
Yeah.
Now, Kyle's got a good chin because he's took a few heavy ones.
Absolutely. Yeah.
He's just loading up that right hand.
Yeah, he's just absorbing those body shots.
Kyle just keeps going round to his right, and he'll take the power out of that right hand every time. Keep going round. If he goes round to his right, he's going to take the power out.
You're talking about
Kyle. If Kyle comes round to his right,
yeah.
It makes it harder for Scott to throw his looping right hand, which he's going to be out of sync with him, isn't he? So
yeah.
Hence he won't get hit with it. And he can do that with his hands down. Fingers crossed, Scott doesn't use the initiative and hit with the left hook.
I don't know if that's Scott's style, but very flat-footed as a boxer.
Yeah.
A little surprising for me.
Very good fight from both fighters.
Yeah, I think Scott put up a really good show there. Just throwing some bombs, absolutely. And Kyle just kept on coming back. Had some really good straight shots. But yeah, great fight from both of them. Go down to the judges. I don't know, I'm gonna call that one, but I think Kyle got that.
Yeah, personal opinion, for me, red corner.
But like I was saying, Scott was throwing some haymakers. And he put up a really good fight. He was constant. Yeah.
The judges have reached a majority decision. Your winner, in the red corner,
surprising, Scott, because
I'm giving up to him like, for going the whole distance. Scott Hammers!
And it's not like Scott Hammers can't fight, you know?
Yeah.
I was just shocked at so many of those overhand one, two,
yeah,
three,
yeah,
like
yeah.
Crazy.
You know, Kyle was throwing combinations.
And that, at the end of the day, is what scored the best.
Yeah.